Hello learners, this is Dr. Vishal Sood, teacher educator. In the last unit, we have studied about elementary education and different schemes that have been launched by different state government to achieve the target of universal elementary education. There are many constitutional provisions in Indian Constitution to achieve this target of universal elementary education. Earlier, Article 45 was there, which was later on in 2009 replaced with RTE Act 2009 under Article 21A, there which makes right to education a fundamental right for all the children. Now, in order to achieve this target of universal elementary education, a number of projects have earlier been launched by different state governments and the union government in the nation. One of such projects was Shiksha Karmi project in the state of Rajasthan, which was launched to achieve this target. Today, we are going to discuss about this Shiksha Karmi project. This discussion will focus on five major points. First, the Shiksha Karmi project, how this project got emerged, how this project came into existence. The second major focus of this discussion will be the objectives of Shiksha Karmi project. Then we will discuss about the strategies under Shiksha Karmi project, what strategies had been adopted by the state government of Rajasthan under this project to achieve the target of universal elementary education. Then we will also focus on different interventions that have been initiated by the state government under Shiksha Karmi project to achieve the target of UEE. Then we will also discuss about the major achievements of this Shiksha Karmi project. So today we will focus on these aspects. Now first, Shiksha Karmi project, how this project got emerged. First, this project was jointly implemented by Government of Rajasthan with the assistance from the Swedish International Development Authority, that is SIDA. Now, how this project came into existence? First, this project was conceptualized on account of the absenteeism of the teachers in the schools in the remote villages. As you have noticed, that the teacher absenteeism is a problem that is not existence to in today, but it is in existence for a longer past. So, in order to remove this problem of teacher absenteeism, this project of Shiksha Karmi was launched, was conceptualized by the state government of Rajasthan. In the state of Rajasthan, this was witnessed that in the remote villages, the teachers who are non-village teachers and non-resident teachers remained absent for many days, and the schools, they remain closed, or there was no provision of education to the children. Hence, the government thought of to initiate a project which is then known as Shiksha Karmi project. This is the substitution. This project is the substitution of the primary school teachers in single teacher school by a team of two local residents or the educational workers called Shiksha Karmis. Now, what happened? The primary school teacher who remained absent, the government thought of replacing that teacher or the substituting that teacher with the two local residents who are educated, who have certain level of qualification, and they were engaged as the educational workers in that particular primary school, and they were named as Shiksha Karmis. These Shiksha Karmis were not the government officials, rather they are the volunteer workers who had to work for the education of the children of that local village. So this is a scheme of substituting the primary school teachers in the single teacher school by a team of two local residents who were named as Shiksha Karmis. Here, the most important feature of this Shiksha Karmi project is that is there was no insistence or there was no such condition of prescribed educational qualification for the local Shiksha Karmis. Rather, there was a provision of continual training and academic support for those local teachers. Now, what the government did, what was the major provision of that this Shiksha Karmi project, that even if the local residents did not possess the prescribed educational qualification to for being a teacher, those local residents were included as Shiksha Karmis, were involved in education of the local children, and they were provided a continual support, continual training for upgrading their skills, for upgrading their knowledge, for upgrading their attendance, for upgrading the professional part. So this was the major feature of the Shiksha Karmi project, that there was no insistence on prescribed educational qualification for local Shiksha Karmis. Rather, they were involved in professional development programs to upgrade their skills. Now, what were the objectives of this Shiksha Karmi project? First, if we go to the objectives of this Shiksha Karmi project, the first one was universal primary education with SS and achievement. Universal primary education, earlier the universal elementary education, when the Sarv Shiksha Abhiyan was not launched, earlier there was district primary education program which was launched throughout India in 1994. So before that, in 1992, this project of Shiksha Karmi was launched, and its main objective was universal primary education. And this universal primary education has two major objectives, that is universal assess and universal achievement. Universal assess means the there should be a reach, the primary education should be within the reach of the children, for all children who belong to a particular village. And universal achievement means minimum levels of learning should be possessed or should be attained by the children, so that the quality of education do not suffer. So the main objective of Shiksha Karmi project was the universal primary education. The second objective of universal primary education of this Shiksha Karmi project is equal educational opportunities to adults and children of lower caste and poorest sections. This was witnessed in the state of Rajasthan, that the educational opportunities to the adults, to the children of the lower caste, to the socially deprived sections of the society and the poorest sections of the society who are economically not sound, they were not given equal opportunities for getting education, at least even up to the primary level. So this Shiksha Karmi project was started so that the local residents of the village get involved in providing training or education to the children. And this when this project was started, the local residents of the villages, they started sending their children to the schools, because the persons who were actually involved in teaching were also of their own community, belonged to their own community. So this was also one of the objective of Shiksha Karmi project, that is to provide equal educational opportunities to the adults and the children of lower caste and poorest sections of the society. Another objective of Shiksha Karmi project is to reduce dropout rate among girls. What was witnessed in the state of Rajasthan at that time, that the girls were being not sent to the schools on account of unawareness among the parents, and secondly, the teachers in the schools were not there. The teachers were either non-village teachers or were non-residents. That's why the parents were not willing to send them to the schools. So Shiksha Karmi project was launched in the state to reduce dropout rate among girls and improve the enrollment, retention and attendance of the girl students in the primary schools. Another objective of Shiksha Karmi project is to improve equality for women and empower them about their rights, about their status in the society. The women were not considered equal to men and they were deprived of their rights. So Shiksha Karmi project was launched, and in this project, the female teachers who were educated or who were having a certain level of educational qualification were also involved in this project to provide education to the girl child and empower the women. Another objective of this Shikshakarmi project was the quality improvement by adopting content to the local needs. Now what happened? The content or the curriculum was adopted to the local needs under this project that generated interest among the parents as well as the children, and this got resulted in the improvement of the quality at the primary level. So these were the six major objectives of the Shikshakarmi project in Rajasthan. The first was the universal primary education. The second one was the equal educational opportunities to the adults and children of lower caste, socially deprived sections of the society, poorest sections of the society. Then reducing dropout rate among girls, improving enrollment, retention and attendance among them, equality for women and their empowerment, and overall quality improvement at the primary level. Now you can see in these two pictures that in one picture a female Shikshakarmi is teaching to the children, and one is one local school where a small girl who is elder in age, who has learned up to the fifth level, was involved in providing education to her younger ones. So these were the main features of Shikshakarmi project, where females were involved to enhance women empowerment as well as girls enrollment and reduce dropout rate among them. So now, what strategies were adopted under Shikshakarmi project? We will now discuss on these strategies. First one was the greater decentralization and community involvement. The main feature of this Shikshakarmi project was the decentralization of the powers, decentralization of the authorities to the grassroots level. And the local community members were involved in this project to improve the educational status of the people, particularly living in the remote areas. Second one is the constant interaction between the government authorities, village community, Shikshakarmis, Shiksha Sahyogis, NGOs and self-help groups, etc. There was a provision, this strategy was adopted under this Shikshakarmi project, that there should be a constant interaction, there should be a continual interaction between different government authorities who are responsible for implementing the elementary education or the primary education in the state, and the village community who are the beneficiaries of those schemes, Shikshakarmis who are to educate the children, the NGOs who are working for the awareness of the local people. So there should be a constant interaction on continual basis, on regular basis, so that the feedback, the input should be received from the grassroots level, and accordingly the education should be imparted to the children of those local areas. So this was the strategy adopted under Shikshakarmi project to involve the local community. Then the other strategy adopted under Shikshakarmi project was to promote gender and social sensitivity in the access. The access to primary education should there be no bar on account of gender. All girls, all boys should have equal access to education, primary education, and no discrimination on the basis of social aspects like caste, category or economic status. There should be no bar on anybody to the elementary education or the primary education at that time. This was the strategy. Another strategy was to design, organize and conduct training for Shikshakarmi trainers and oversee training of Shikshakarmis. The Shikshakarmis who were the educators for the local people, the educational qualification was not considered. They were trained, they were provided academic support on continual basis by the authorities. So this strategy was adopted, that the training should have adequate and appropriate components so that those Shikshakarmis could provide appropriate education and educational experiences to the children. So this was the strategies to provide the training on continual basis to the Shikshakarmis, and the trainers who are involved in providing training to the Shikshakarmis were also provided training by the higher authorities at the district and the state level. The other training, the other major feature of this, the strategic feature of this Shikshakarmi project was the inbuilt monitoring process at the village, at the block, at the headquarter, and at the state level. This monitoring was done to improve, to find out any bottlenecks, to find out any hindrances in the educational process, and to make recommendations for removing those bottlenecks or to remove those hindrances so that the target of universal elementary primary education could be achieved in the state. Then there was provision of joint biannual reviews by SIDA, that is Swedish International Development Agency, the Government of India and the Government of Rajasthan. The progress of this Shikshakarmi project was reviewed by the external agencies, by the Government of India and the Government of Rajasthan at a time of 6 months. And on the basis of these reviews, the new strategies were framed and implemented accordingly. Then there was independent evaluation by the teams consisting of national and international experts. The Shikshakarmi project was evaluated many times, and in the those evaluation studies, it came to forefront that this Shikshakarmi project has resulted in achieving many milestones in the state of Rajasthan. So these were the major strategic features of this Shikshakarmi project in Rajasthan. Now, what interventions under Shikshakarmi project were made in Rajasthan? There were 5 major interventions in the state of Rajasthan which were made under Shikshakarmi project. First was day center. This day center was also known as Anganshala, and in this day center intervention, the existing primary schools were run by the Shikshakarmis, where the teachers were absent or were teachers were not available. Those schools were handed over to the local residents or the local educational workers known as Shikshakarmis, and those primary schools were run by those Shikshakarmis and known as day centers. Then the second intervention was Angan Pathshala. To encourage sustained participation of girls in primary education, these Angan Pathshalas were established. These Angan Pathshalas were established so that the participation of girls in primary education could be enhanced to an optimum level. Earlier, the parents were not willing to send their girls to the schools, to the primary schools, because of accessibility, because of long distance of the schools from their homes. So this strategy, this intervention strategy was adopted under this Shikshakarmi project, that Angan Pathshalas were created, were established so that the girls could participate in the process of primary education and they start attending the primary education. On account of these Angan Pathshalas, it was witnessed that the parents started sending their girl child to the schools, because the schools were now less distance from their homes. The second intervention under Angan Pathshala was local educated rural women were entrusted to teach at least 15 girls of the neighborhood. Now, this is one of the major feature of this Angan Pathshala, that the local educated rural women from the same community, they were given the responsibility to teach at least 15 girls of their neighborhood. So this Angan Pathshalas were established, and the local resident rural women, they were given the responsibility. They, in one sense, they got the employment. Their empowerment was also took place, and the education of the girls, the girl children, that also improved on account of this Angan Pathshala. Then the third intervention was Prahar Pathshala. These Prahar Pathshalas were actually the night schools, and these night schools were established for the children who were unable to attend the day centers or the ashram shalas, they were not able to attend those angan paathshalas or the other things. For them, night schools were established under this Siksha Karmi project, and the teachers from the labor class or the from the poor sections who were on account of one or the other reason were not able to attend the schools in the day times, they were given this education through the night schools, and these night schools under Siksha Karmi project were named as Prahar Paathshalas. Now you can see in this picture that one female Shiksha Karmi is teaching to the children in this Prahar Paathshala. This is a night school which was established under Siksha Karmi project, and female teachers were also involved in this Prahar Paathshalas or the night schools, and the teachers who were not able to attend the school in the day times, they were imparted education at the night. In the second picture, you can see that a female Shiksha Karmi, a Mahila Shiksha Karmi, is involved in providing education to the children of the local area. Now, this female Shiksha Karmi is involved in imparting training or in imparting education to the local children of that region. Now, after this, we will discuss about two more interventions. That one is Mahila Prashikshan Kendra. Mahila Prashikshan Kendra is female training center. The female Shiksha Karmis who were appointed under Siksha Karmi project as educational worker or were entrusted the responsibility of imparting education to the girls of the neighborhood, there was a provision to provide them training. Now, in order to provide them training, there was female teacher training centers were established under Siksha Karmi project, and these female teachers or the Mahila Siksha Karmis were imparted education, were imparted training on the related to different subjects of their interest and the pedagogical techniques, how to deal with the children, how to impart them education. So, Mahila Prashikshan Kendras were also established under Siksha Karmi project. Another intervention under Siksha Karmi project was integrated approach. The students who were disabled or physically handicapped and were not able to attend the schools were integrated in the mainstream under this Siksha Karmi project. So, integrated education for disabled children was also one of the major feature, major intervention of Siksha Karmi project, that the education under Siksha Karmi project was given in an integrated manner, in an inclusive manner. So, in nutshell, we can say that the major five interventions under Siksha Karmi project was the day centers, or which are known as Angan Shalas also, where the existing primary schools were run by the Siksha Karmis. The second was the Angan Paathshalas, where the local educated rural women were involved, were given the responsibility to teach the girls of the neighborhood. Then the night schools or the Prahar Paathshalas for the children who were unable to attend the day schools. And then the fourth was Mahila Prashikshan Kendra to impart training to the Mahila Shiksha Karmis or the female teachers, female educational workers, so that they can upgrade their knowledge, so that they can upgrade their skills. And the last was imparting education to the children in an integrated manner or in an inclusive manner under this project. So, these were the interventions under Siksha Karmi project. Now, what were the major achievements of this Siksha Karmi project in Rajasthan? At this time, the state runs 2,600 day schools, those are known as Angan Shalas, where 48,229 and 97 Angan Shalas, Prahar Paathshalas and 99 Angan Shalas are functional. In these schools, 6,213 Siksha Karmis serve 2.16 lakh children, 40% of which are girls. Now, this is one of the major achievements, that at present there are 2,600 day schools, 48,229 prayer paathshalas and 97 anganshalas. And mostly girls, 40% of the enrollment belongs to the girls in these schools. Monthly attendance rate has increased substantially from 58% to 84% on account of these interventions made under Shiksha Karmi projects. So this is a substantial improvement. If we see that from 58% to 84%, the attendance rate on monthly basis has increased. The other achievement is that is there was six-fold increase in the enrollment of children in the age group of 6 to 14 years, that is 37% to 83% in Shiksha Karmi schools and prayer paathshalas. Now, this can also be taken as a major improvement or major achievement of the Shiksha Karmi project, that the age group of 6 to 14 years children has an enrollment improvement from 37% to 83%. The increase in retention of the children has increased from an average of about 19% to 65%. So these were the major achievements. If we see, there were the appointment of the Shiksha Karmis, then there was the improvement in enrollment of the children, there was improvement in retention of the children, and there was improvement in attendance rate of the children on account of Anganshalas, on account of Prayer Paathshalas, and on account of involvement of local residents or the educational workers or the Shiksha Karmis. So this Shiksha Karmi project can be termed to be a major milestone in the educational development of state of Rajasthan. And this Shiksha Karmi project has become a model for other states in Himachal Pradesh. On the basis of this project, volunteer teacher scheme was launched. Under that volunteer teacher scheme, the local residents who have studied up to or who have got educational qualification up to 10th level were engaged as volunteer teachers or swayamsevi adhyapaks in the primary schools to remove the shortage of teachers in primary schools. That scheme was launched in 1993 in the state of Himachal Pradesh. So we can say that Shiksha Karmi project is a milestone, is a model for the other state to achieve the target of universal elementary education. So in this today's discussion, we discussed about the Shiksha Karmi project, how this project got conceptualized, how this project came into existence, how this project was given a shape. Then we also discussed about objectives of Shiksha Karmi project. Then what were the major objectives? That was universal primary education with universal access and universal enrollment. Then the then equality of educational opportunity of all children, then empowerment of women. So these were the major objectives of Shiksha Karmi project about which we discussed. Then we also discussed about the strategies which were adopted under Shiksha Karmi project to achieve the target of universal primary education. Then we discussed about the interventions, five interventions that were undertaken under Shiksha Karmi project. Those five interventions were day centers, prayer paathshalas, angan paathshalas, then mahila prashikshan kendras, and another major achievements of Shiksha Karmi project were discussed by all of us. Now it is hoped that you have understood about the major aspects of Shiksha Karmi projects. So thank you.